notice also, Marvin, even with the history of your show, of your content, you actually included a lot of collaborations, right, with people who are probably like-minded, you know, as you. In your opinion, like, how did you build your content? And in your opinion, what do you think was like the greatest hit in terms of category in your channel?
My channel is, I know it already, since it's investing, you will not get, and since it's also catered mostly to Filipinos, unlike the ones that post American stocks or those that cater to the whole world, their audience will be bigger. So I know that my videos won't really have virality, but what I can see there is I have consistency, meaning the ones that would watch me, they would watch me regularly. So you won't get a million views, but even those small views, and the people watch it for every day, that's why my views are very, very, if you add the views per month and you compare it to other channels that have larger followings, my views are way up there also.
Yeah.
But per category, I think it's still the more technical ones, the stock trading videos, and then success stories also of people that, I don't know, have started from somewhere and then they're sharing their story. So, those are the two broad categories of it. So, stock trading videos, then success stories of people.
Interesting. So, what's your favorite, or how has YouTube benefited you? Of course, aside from it being your platform to really promote your advocacy on financial freedom. It's also your, should I say, your career is somewhat documented in a, you know, in a platform. What do you think is the greatest benefit that it added to you?
Dami! One is, if I was able to video myself in the 2008 crash telling people, this is the best time to invest, that would have been so nice. Eh? I'm reliving it also that there's a crash happening.
Right.
By 2030, 2040, I can always say, look at this, in 2020, I told people, this, you should have invested now. So you now have a reference also on something that is momentous. That's one. Number two is the access. Because of it, CEOs from different companies, listed companies in the stock market, there's a way for me to have access to them. Whereas if I was just a normal stock trader, it would not have been possible. I was able to meet sila Manny Pangilinan, Ayala, and they were all. As a normal stock trader, I'm not so sure if it's something that a lot of people get to, access. But it opened up my world to different facets also. Then number three is moving. The reason why I get to post more videos now is, I see it's easy. Before, I have to go to ABS-CBN to share my thoughts. The interview is 15 minutes. The travel time is 2 hours going there, 2 hours going back. Now, you can just say the same thing and then broadcast it on YouTube, and it's catered to the people who really like to watch stocks also.
So, right.
It allows me to, I guess, efficiently communicate everything, because you can be anywhere. And since prior to this coronavirus, I would normally travel, so kunyari, the market was down at this point in time and I'm in a different place. I just need to get a camera, share my thoughts on what's happening at that exact moment. So the ease, it's very practical, it's very easy. And then I guess in terms of benefit also, that's where everyone's attention is right now. Even before coronavirus. It's about knowing where people's attention is. So if people are in traffic, they're not reading the newspaper, they're watching YouTube, they're in Facebook, they're in Instagram, they're on TikTok. And it's a realization that if you want to influence a lot of people, YouTube is not the future. YouTube is already the present. YouTube, whatever will happen in the future, everything will be done by whatever you can do from this.
Right. That's true. I love it, no? Because I think, Marvs, you're also a fit for a YouTube personality, if I could term it like that, because you're very real, and at the same time, you're okay with being raw. Kasi it's so hard also to build content when you want to perfect everything. You know, and I guess people are really looking for authenticity, like what you offer. Kasi, you know, you don't really have to hide anything, like perfect your environment and stuff, your backdrop, everything. I'd like for you to have an avenue, Marvin, also to maybe share a little bit as my final question. Share a little bit or give tips to those who would aspire to start their own channel or their own YouTube account. What would be your advice?
Okay. Before that, I wanted to say something based on what you said. You mentioned that some of it is raw. It's also about studying the numbers. I have already 1,400 videos in YouTube, and I've seen through the numbers. Having a very polished video versus having a raw video, there's no correlation. There's a significant jump in views. So I realized that maybe because I'm not a travel channel, I'm not something that gives cinematic highlights. Because before, the older videos, may mga cinematic pa yun. If I'm walking in Iceland, I make videos of what happened there before I talk. But no difference. So with what you said, number one, you have to know your audience if you want to start your own YouTube channel. That's very, very important. Sometimes people make videos because that's what they think they like. But if you really want people to watch you, you have to make videos that your audience will like. And that's why there are a lot of raw videos now. Even the newer ones, there are a lot of raw videos, no edit, because I realized it. No edit versus with edit, the views are the same, the watch time is the same, the ability for people to share it, it's also the same, because I know that's my audience. And then people will always say, don't make long videos because people's attention spans are short. But my videos are long, and people watch it, people stay. So it goes back also to knowing who they are. And the way to do that is to make a lot of videos. Because if you don't have a lot of videos, you don't know what people like. So my suggestion also, if you want to start something, make 20 different videos, and then among the 20 videos, the one that people watch the most, you make more of that. So you'll never know it. You'll never know what people will like. And then number three, the reason why di ako naubusan na sasabihin is because I like what I'm talking about. That's the biggest, I think, X factor in everything. Because if you're doing it because it's something that you know, it's something that you're skillful, pwede naman. But there will come a point in time that you're tired, you're not going to do it anymore. There will come a point in time where it's not exciting. But for me, this is something that's exciting. That's why my goal, my internal metric, my goal is to make 10,000 videos. I'm still at 1.4. It's a very, very long road. But anyway, I'm gonna try it. And until now naman, since it's exciting, I won't stop doing it. So my suggestion, if you're good at cooking, but you're not, you want to make a YouTube channel about cooking, but you're not passionate about cooking, might as well find something connected to cooking that you're more passionate about. So it can be reviewing other cooking channels, not per se you cooking per se. It has to be something that you really love so that it's sustainable. So that on video 275, hindi ka tatama rin. And then, number four is, how many tips do you want me to give? Okay, number four, you must be willing that people always want to have a lot of subscribers, but what they don't know, make up yun. The more subscribers you have, the more people will disagree with you also. That's part of it. And I've had so many people come to me and then they quit after doing 10 videos because while they were making the video, someone said to them, ang pangit mo, taba mo, huwag ka na mag-YouTube, and they got hurt. So, so sabi ko, when those things happen, you must be willing to either, if you can't absorb that, you have to stop also. Kasi it will just amplify. The more followers you get, the more subscribers you get, it will just get even bigger. So it's part of the territory that if you want to influence more people, you must be willing that, especially now online, it's easy to make a bad talk, it's easy to make a bad comment, it's easy to say something. So I think having the emotional fortitude to be able to withstand whatever people are doing in the comment section, or not reading the comment section at all, is very, very important if you're starting. And lastly, I guess, don't do it for subscribers. Don't do it for money. If you're doing it for money, then I think at first, no, it's a good motivator. But when things are not going your way and you're not getting your results, it's easy for people to quit if money is their greatest motivator in doing it. So you have to find something that is bigger than you. That's why you're going to do YouTube. It could be, you think it's your calling, it's your passion, it's something that you're meant to do, you have a message that you want to share. But don't make earning money from YouTube your greatest motivator. Because you hear a lot of stories of people who have made a lot of money in YouTube, but what they don't talk about is the 90% that would do YouTube channels that are struggling. So, there.
I love it! Thank you so much, Marbs! Grabe, dami ko nakuha doon. I love also especially what you said na, you know, when you get bigger, like you, you know, having people disagree with you. And I guess it's really important that you know your real purpose while you're putting up your channel, while you're using this social media app, YouTube, to really share your thoughts and your opinions or what you know, your expertise. Basically, you have to know your identity as well. Bashers may come. Hindi ba pwedeng delete mo na lang yung comments para hindi ka ma-affect?
I think it depends on the person already. If it affects you, that you can't stand seeing it, di-block mo na lang, hide mo na lang. But there are some people also that hindi nila pinapansin. But there are some people also,
yes,
they engage them even more. Yung bashers, kasi in YouTube, the more engagements you have, the more YouTube will push you in the algorithm. So, some of them, they can really withstand it. So, pag may basher, talagang pinupok pa nila lalo so they get more engagement. Pero kaya nila yun. So, depends. It depends on the person also doing it.
Wow, interesting. That's good. I love what you shared. Definitely, Marvs, and of course, if you would give us more of your time, we'll have another session of this. For those of you who have learned a lot so far, please comment below what you learned from Marvin. And if you want more, just say, I want more of Marvin Germo. And don't forget again to subscribe to his YouTube channel. That's his name, Marvin Germo. And all his books, I'll flash it at the end of this show. So make sure to get that, especially for such a time as this. Even more so, actually, you know, we will get out of this this ECQ, this COVID situation. So it's best that everyone is also prepared. And I'm sure you'll get a lot from what Marvin has to tell you from his resources. So thank you so much again, Marvin. I'll see you soon.
Okay, thank you for having me.
Thanks.